What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to the Russell Street Report film room here on Two Guys Watching Football, where we are getting in to the tail of the tape brought to you by TNL Window Tinting. Stay tuned for after the video for a nice little ad read about the services they could bring you. Today, we're going to be diving into Travis Jones, who notched his first sack in the NFL. He played an increased role up to 37 snaps. We're probably going to see a little bit more of that with the absence of Michael Pierce. And in addition to more snaps, we saw an increase in his level of play, you know, a little bit more pressure, a little bit better run defending, some more plays on the ball. A lot of things that I think fans are going to be very, very excited about. So without further ado, let's get straight into the film. Let's go see what Travis Jones was up to.
I get started here with Travis Jones' sack. I'm missing the start of the snap, but essentially what you're seeing here is Jones attacking this inside shoulder, going at Daniel Jones. And basically what you're getting is just him running right through the hip. And so he has that left hand, and I believe it gets up into his face mask, and I'll show you 76 turns and starts motioning towards the ref. But he's basically trying to take that inside hand and play that inside shoulder. And he basically, what I call, runs through his hip. And so you can kind of see him pushing off on the head here. And he runs right through the hip, which creates the space that he needed to get to Jones and bring him down. And so that's just a beautiful sack. And then you watch, see 76 motioning for his flag, but he ain't going to get it. But, you know, really good rep there for Travis Jones. I think it really showed, we'll go back just through it one more time, his ability to power through the hip there was really impressive. To maintain leverage on basically split his body in half, and that seems to be where he's having success as a pass rusher. We'll see it here later, and we'll also see where he's getting kind of stalled by not having a different set of pass rush moves to go to. But, you know, it works for him here. He just powers through, gets the wrap up, finishes the play. And then you're going to get him here against 64. And it's essentially the same thing we just saw. So he's going to, I think it's Ben Bredesen actually. So he's going to, is it Ben Bredesen? I don't even know. He's going to split his body in half. And then you're going to see right here, he's going to push off and then he's going to dip that arm and rip up under. But really what he's having success doing is splitting that body in half, getting that inside hand up here, and starting to drive a little bit to get some depth in the pocket. And then what he really needs to do more consistently is what he does on this one and pair it with a pass rush move. And that's where he dips and rips his arm to create that space and then get some pressure in there. So I don't know if he would have got a pressure on that, but I think you got to feel pretty good about those back-to-back plays there. Now, there are still a few plays like this. And so I picked this one, I'll run it through one more time, as a negative play. You have him right here as a 2-eye tech. And there's just not a lot going on. And this has happened a few times where he sort of runs out of a game plan. He hasn't really, he's trying to use his long arm here into Feliciano. And he's using a long arm inside, but turning his body into the same spot. And I've seen him do this a few times. And then he collapses and his hands are inside and he basically loses any leverage. So that's, and you can see right here, Feliciano works that hand up. So this is where I'd like to see, this is where splitting the body in half, because the difference between the past rep and the other one, and this one, sorry, on other reps, he would try and get this hand into this armpit, split his body in half, run through the hip, but he just stays square to him and then lets him get all the leverage by getting his hands inside his chest plate. So this is where Travis Jones needs to continue to develop, continue to expand his pass rush moves, because this happens quite a few times. And so I just want to show it. It's more just so I'm telling a concrete, comprehensive story and not just showing you all the sunshine and rainbows. But that's just a critical look at Travis Jones. I think we get some run plays here. Got him here as the one tech. Really impressive work against the double team. In fact, he pushes the double team. You can see it as Barkley's coming up. So he's going to actually get moved decently off front on by the double team. You're going to get the blocker come off, and then gap's here, but Jones pushes his man back. So this is just good recovery strength. See him right there drive his man in, eliminate that gap. So good work by Jones to play smart football there. You know, loses the double team, but recovers really well. Here you're going to get a beautiful stack and shed. We'll run it through and come back. There's a stack, shed, play on. Really good run D. We saw him do this earlier too. So Feliciano, the center, is going to try and take him over. He's just going to get his arms under, plant his foot, and then he is going to shed, bring that arm over. Get right across. Beautiful stack and shed. Exactly what you want to see from a big defensive tackle. And then I don't think they got a hold on this. I'll have to double check, but I showed in the last video that I did on him how he was a value add against zone. And so you see Feliciano takes over leverage on the inside here. But Jones' ability to run with the play and have that athleticism. And then as the edge gets set out here to have this change of direction to come back inside. And you can see his hand on the inside, the Giants' hand. See right there? That, my friends, is a hold. But Jones adjusts really well, gets his hand into him. So his athleticism, his change of direction, that's the difference between a Brandon Williams type and him. Brandon Williams wasn't able to do this type of stuff. So, you know, great run D by him. Got him here over top of 64 again as a 2-eye. Just good hand fighting, setting, you know, basically taking away the gap. But watch right here. Going to get 76 banging down on the double team and then working into Queen. And he just uses that inside hand to throw him completely off. And that's why what causes Barkley to cut. So he's basically just filling that gap. And then forces him back. The guys come in and do the cleanup. So really good stuff here.
So, I mean, you can see a lot of key improvements there. And before we wrap up, we're going to do a very, very quick word from our sponsors.
Grinnell Window Tinting, a family-owned business for over 30 years, has everything you need to protect your most treasured assets from the sun's detrimental ultraviolet rays. Protect your car, your home, and, of course, your family. Every day, your vehicle battles rocks, sand, dirt, scratches, road debris, and bugs, all of which can eat away at your car's paint. Your vehicle's windows and those at home, when unprotected, can bleach your seats, furniture, carpeting, and more while driving up energy costs. Let D&L help. D&L Window Tinting. They put the shade on the sun.
And a huge thank you to D&L Window Tinting for bringing you this episode. But you can see it there from Travis Jones. He's starting to really improve, earn a bigger role, and I think it's going to be very exciting what he puts together. As the season goes on, he's again, Michael Pierce being out gives him a huge opportunity. I think he's out playing Broderick Washington. I will say Brent Urban's one guy that I thought's played really well in limited snaps. So I'm expecting those two to be really rotating some of those inside snaps that you're not seeing from Matabike, Calais Campbell, but very encouraging stuff from Travis Jones. So if you guys enjoyed this breakdown, hit that like button, hit subscribe if you guys are new here. And as always, be good to yourselves, be good to each other. Peace out.